Hey, you're bad. Welcome to Callum's Corner.
Que je suis mortifié. J'ai été absolument humilié aujourd'hui et l'un de vous
is responsible for this. One of you has done this, right?
Sidehead.
Went down to the co-op a little while ago because I needed some milking, right? Milking. I got my little bits in the co-op.
The co-op is an awful supermarket. Why do you shop there, you stinky moron?
This is you.
Calm down, you. Just look at their reviews.
I'm rolling away because my legs are not the care I take every day.
Came out and I got back on my scooter. I'm coming round the corner to get onto the high street just to get started to pick up speed on my scooter.
Oh my god! Oh jeez, oh my god!
And this lady rushes out of a shop and she f***ed me bloody ass. I'm thinking, oh god, that was spaffer. It's one of the anti-bloody scooter brigade. You know, I'm ready for a confrontation. Heckles are raised. You know, bring it on. Rumble in the bloody jungle. Alright, I'll live for that kind of stuff. So, get off my scooter, go with the bosoms and stuff. Alright, my mind's thinking, finally something to cheer me up. And with about 30 seconds, I've gone soft and smooth and I'm not gonna spaff. My testicles are retracting back into me with cringe, right? Hey, my world is coming crashing down. The bosoms are so big and puberty ridden, so, you know, not pleasant for me to look at. Oh my god, I am the Magpiper of bloody paedophilia. She's gonna tell her husband, didn't she? Or her boyfriend or her best friend? You would tell someone, wouldn't you? Callum's Corner is the Magpiper of paedophilia. I am humiliated. All of my bravado is melted into absolute shame, right? She's explaining to me that the shop she's come out of, she owns, and one of her customers mentioned to her a while back that it's called Callum's Corner.
On Google.
Right? She's asked around the village. She's certain, like, who am I? Like, she's been
waiting for me.
She's been wanting to confront me about this.
New challenge. Final round. KO. You win.
Alright. I am absolutely humiliated, and how do I explain this? I'm going on about it, but what am I meant to say? Like, there's a bunch of puberty-ridden teenagers, mean monkeys, who like to try and f*** me up. How do I explain it? Go on, I challenge you. Explain to a late middle-aged posh woman who's never even heard of a meme what has just happened there, right?
Hello, my dear, I'm Sanjay. On the internet, I'm called Callum's Corner. I'm terribly sorry about what has happened to your business's name on Google. Let me explain. I'm what some might call a niche internet celebrity on a site called YouTube. Thousands of people watch the videos I upload. Some of them are young people. I have no idea who's watching because the internet is pretty anonymous. these young individuals have an underdeveloped sense of humor. They are moderately stupid and have been deprived of parental attention. Please take this into consideration, my dear. Anyway, they attempt to find out where I live and get my reaction to various pranks they pull on me. Unfortunately, your humble business has been the target of a prank. It was neither your fault or mine. Regardless, I do apologize.
Thank you for taking the time to explain. You are such an alpha male. Come back to my house and we can fuck.
I'm apologizing, gratuitously apologizing after thinking I was going to have a confrontation that was glorious, right? She is just confused by the whole thing, and in the end, I get back on my scooter with my tail between my legs.
The YouTuber, known as Callum's Corner, aka PewDiePie, has exposed himself as a furry. He also came out as having chlamydia.
To ride a bloody shame through the village, I felt like everyone was looking at me. God almighty, I get home, which should be safe refuge. I get the kettle on, gonna have a cup of tea. That's not a good start to the day, right? I've got to sort that out somehow. Right? Pop the kettle on, it starts boiling. It's, you know, kettle boiling noisy, so I don't hear my bloody gate open, right? By the time I look round, Lenny's out of the garden and he's gone to greet the post lady, right? And,
You are a Tic Tac. I mean, you know, you look at your head, it does actually look like a Tic Tac, which is why people do call you that.
The tension in the room is unbelievable. It's still anyone's game. Put us out of our misery. Who's won?
Ian Moore.
He's dead friendly, Lenny, but he's so big, he pushes up against you. I'm worried he's going to knock people over. So I rush out there, and I calm Lenny down, grab him, and she gives me the post, and she goes, but she's really awkward. Normally, she's really friendly, this post lady. She really likes Lenny. It's just a really awkward encounter. So I'm worried in case Lenny has like, jumped up and like hurt her or something. Anyway,
What did you do with Big Chungus? We know you're the sus imposter, and I saw you vent in electrical.
This is what I see, the back of this, right? Oh, shiny. I'm waiting on a delivery from America at the moment for a small print artwork, mermaid artwork, right? It's lovely, it's not gratuitous, it's hair covers with bosoms and stuff. But it's a really tasteful little print that I'm going to put in a frame in my bedroom. So, you know, it's pleasant for me to look at. And if I get a woman back there, she's going to find it alluring. It might get her in the mood. It's a win-win situation. But I'm thinking, even if it's not that, you know, even if it's not come yet, it's all that glitters is gold, an exciting package. Finally, my day's changing round, right? I turn it over, and that is what is on the other side. Can you see that? Chlamydiatesting.co.uk. Fast track test results. PP. I don't know what PWB is, but it's an urgent delivery, apparently. Return address to sexual health clinic. The discreet home testing. There's nothing discreet about that. It's a shiny, glittery envelope. Discreet, my bloody ass. Oh, my God, I am melting with shame at this point. My testicles are retracting back into me with cringe, right? Hey, my world is coming crashing down. That's why she's awkward with me, the post lady. It's a post lady. I'm thinking that, tactically, that she goes to every house in my village. What if she tells them all? Do they take an oath of secrecy like a doctor? Post people, I don't know. Even if she does that, she's going to tell her husband, isn't she? Or her boyfriend or her best friend. You would tell someone, wouldn't you? It's going to spread. I live in a tiny little village. It's going to spread all round it. What are they going to think? They're going to think I'm so riddled with the clap that I've gone mental and I'm claiming shops. They're going to think I've gone crazy, that I think I'm like a latter-day version of Caligula or something. Jesus Christ, my life is ruined. This is my real life. This isn't like a meme where you're doing something funny that I'm going to react to and find unpleasant online. There are women that I'd like to sleep with in this village. They all think I'm bloody riddled with the clap now. You've gone so over the line this time. You have well and truly crossed the Rubicon.
My corner is, they're awesome.
Jesus Christ, my life is ruined. This is my real life.
The corner came along and to start judging people on their ethnicities.
I'm going to attempt to survive the next 3 days and 3 nights by drinking nothing but alcoholic beverages. What were you thinking? Do you think I've gone soft because I got fat during lockdown and stopped uploading very much? This is you. Silent but bloody violent, why give up my advantage? I will dedicate myself, I will search all the little discords and forums and find out which one of you did this. You have well and truly crossed the line. Honestly, all you need to know is that shit just got real. Idiots.
Was incredible. That was amazing. I really just reading along the block there. The amount of effort that must have taken to lose. No wonder it took me only once and once.
كل دول بزوجة بتاعه اللي تبقى عنده مرة ايه بس كده